But you know what? We're here on the draft. Enough of the talk. Enough of the predictions. Mm-hmm. We're here to say what we see for RRQ and Cosmic University.
Saying what we are seeing indeed, and what I see right now is a Galio ban and a Rakan ban. Galio most likely will be banned out because... Oh, okay. Here's the thing. Usually when a team bans out Galio, they would want to have a lineup that's a bit melee-centric. Again, Galio does have the taunt, so he is just a huge problem. Top that off with a Fiora and a Olaf ban. Olaf, need I say more? I mean, this guy with Ragnarok, he is just crazy, as well as Fiora. Very mobile and could just take down your carries for the side of RRQ. You have the usual Ziggs ban and Camille apparently still not going to be seeing the light of day, but Ziggs with his bombs and his power is still a constant threat in the meta. With that RRQ, Renekton is open. They will most likely hover that and maybe lock it in.
Yeah, traditional Renekton lock-in though for RRQ is their first pick. I think they want to have that flexible top laner and also very sustainable at least. But Cosmic University, you know what? We're gonna see Nunu and Willump gonna be hovered once again. A very strong tanky champions, and I think that also supports the statement that they are hovering onto the brand as well for their second rotation picks. Wherein you need those tanky frontliners if you want to have the squishy backlines.
Can I just say that it's been a while since I saw a Garen brand lane, so I kind of miss a champion, but top that off with a Nunu and Willump jungle. I guess they just want to have this very sturdy front line and a very, very irritating man with Snowball right at their face, so a lot of CC and a lot of burst damage. RRQ though, they will take a hold of their dragon lane duo, which is Kai'Sa and Janna. It's been a while since I've saw Janna in the dragon lane. Usually it's Nami or Lulu, I don't know, but mm-hmm. Yeah, and even Rakan. Kai'Sa though, still definitely one of the strongest ADCs available in the meta. Looks like, wow, Cosmic University, they locked in Soraka. Hello, Autolus.
they've done this in, I think, their game on the first series, where it comes to the single elimination, right? And Cosmic University with Soraka, I'm expecting it to go to the Winter Fimble Winter route, and then the Spirit Visage for that, HP regen item. Mm-hmm. For that sustainability for his team. So we can expect a lot of things for Soraka from Arthros.
Yeah, and top that off with the Saya, most likely going over to the ADC, Lara 1. I mean, when it comes to the late game, Cosmic University, they just really have a lot of trust and respect for their ADC. So give him any ADC that he wants. Could even be Vayne, and he will just carry the living hell out of that match. Now, the last pick for the side of Cosmic University will be a Diana. Talking about control and burst, but at the same time, RRQ, they have their hands on this Orianna. I love seeing Xin Zhao, because if you're gonna look at the lineup for Cosmic University, it screams team fight. And one of the ways to stop a team fight is you disengage. I mean, Gragas is available, but I guess we do not see that much in the PH meta or SCA meta even. So they will just opt with the second best champion, which is Xin Zhao. The band's locked in and the draft already ready. Let us take and dive inside, rather, game number one. Again, this is RRQ versus Cosmic University. The King of Kings versus the aliens. I don't know. That's the first thing I thought with the logo.
I mean, sure thing. I mean, it looks like a UFO coming from Cosmic University, but as a whole, right now, we're seeing a very traditional thing from both teams. RRQ went for the four-man roam into the mid lane just to factor it out the wave, and Cosmic University does the same thing, but rather than four, they went in for three so that Nunu and Willem can go for the jungle much more earlier. Because as you all know, Nunu and Willump at level 1 doesn't really have that much damage to fast clear on the jungle camps.
Yeah, I mean, you know, the more the merrier, I guess. Also, I have a question. Do you see that skin on Nunu?
Yeah.
By default, he throws out snowballs, right? And he has this huge snowball. But then, if he has that skin, it becomes this gooey slime. Would you still call that snowballs?
Well,
I personally won't.
Barf ball. It's a barf ball from Sayonara.
Okay, nice. I'm gonna use that for tonight. But jumping back into the dragon lane side, it looks like Maze received quite the damage there, but she will be A-okay given that it is still the early game pokes coming out from both Saya and Soraka. I mean, Soraka with the silence, Soraka with the early game damage, it could really be a problem for Kai'Sa and Janna here. But looking up at the baron lane side, Garen, a very, very healthy Garen, was able to chunk down a huge amount of damage on this Renekton, and Renekton will just go into the Rift Herald pit, and he will just watch Xin Zhao take that Rift Scuttler.
Yeah, and they're gonna do so. I mean, RRQ right now is steadily here in this game. However, look at the Goldie. Cosmic University already has a couple. 600 gold to say the least. This is just the beginning of time, but I think this states something, because RRQ went in for the four-man roam, keeps on roaming towards elsewhere, and Cosmic University just keeps farming.
That is true. And looking at the movement of Cosmic University right now, I thought he was going to go with the gank, but apparently he is just going to steal out the neutral jungle creep. Soraka will make her way near their jungle, but then go with the recoil, and there's a barf ball that you were talking about. Sayonara, of course, will not be able to target anyone but that buff, and looks like it will be buff secured for this new recalls coming through for both Marquee and Maze as well. Not much action at the mid lane though, given that these two powerhouse mages, powerhouse mid laners, are just taking their sweet time ramping up on the burst damage.
And this is very interesting, because traditionally when Xin Zhao hits level 3, he will roam. When he hits level 5, he will roam.
Initially, yes.
And at the moment, he's still not doing it. Maybe now, he's going for the mid lane, but however, they're fighting a Diana under the turret, which you can't really engage if that's the case.
It's not something you'd want, especially Diana has the Moonfall available. I guess that's the reason why RRQ, they will just take a step back, it's back to the drawing board, and maybe they possibly, they could even start targeting either the Baron lane or the Dragon lane. And looking up top, looks like Nunu did try to join Garen there, but Garen is the only one that's going to try to go up against this Renekton. Silence is coming through, but you still have the stuns coming out from this hide. With that, Garen does get pinned down, but the damage is not yet sufficient, so he gets to live another day. Here comes Sayonara with the barf ball. Apparently was not able to ramp up for it enough, and he just let it go and literally allowed this crocodile to do what he wants.
Yeah, and still in over his blood in 3 minutes and 45 seconds. However, what we will have is the Ocean Dragon in the Rift Herald at 10 seconds. We might expect maybe RRQ to go for the Ocean Dragon if they want to go for that late game. But considering you now have two Rift Herald in game, I think it's a huge priority right now to go for the Rift Herald instead.
Mm-hmm. I actually have to agree. Even unless it's an Infernal Dragon for the first dragon, most teams, especially the teams from SEA, they highly focus on the macro power, like the macro playing kind of game in the Wild Rift, and that includes taking down towers, playing the objective game, and nothing is better than being able to get your hands on the Rift Herald and converting that to turret takedown. So, okay, looks like Cosmic University, they are clumping in this Rift Herald pit. But Hyde will just have to hit that recall button, look at and allow to the Rift Herald to get taken down by Cosmic University. Garen as well will just try to get the first blood turret in different parts of the map. RRQ was able to get the first Drake of the game.
And that is stating up for the late game potential for RRQ, as we stated a while ago, but Cosmic University gets a tower first blood.
Now here it is, and it's going to be the flash in for the side of RRQ. Move will come through, but apparently damage is not enough. Instead, blue team was able to get the first blood. Layla saying goodbye, and here comes Sayonara with that barf ball. Apparently there will be no knock-up. Snowball is going to come through. Stunts connecting with that. The kill does go over to Garen. At the very least, Cosmic University was able to get one kill in their pocket. 1k gold lead, and again, a Rift Herald in their belts.
Yeah. So right now, if you're looking at the standings, it's 1-for-1 in turrets, 1-for-1 in objectives, because Cosmic University, do take note, has gotten the Rift Herald a while ago that was summoned into the mid lane. And then when it comes to gold as well, it is pretty even. If this stays consistent up until the 15-minute mark, we're looking at RRQ's Kai'Sa to be able to get the second core item, third core item, which will be very insane later on. But huge respect still for Lara 1, because if Saya is able to get a huge positioning advantage, he can just CC the enemy team and get that down for his team.
I actually remember Marquee in a different tournament. He only ever used Kai'Sa before. Seeing him back on this champion, it just it's a huge throwback, you know. And you really know how strong he is on this champion. The fact that RRQ picked this up in their lineup for the Best of 3, it just speaks volume. Let's see how well will Marky be able to help his team in the late game with that new skin, by the way. What a beautiful skin alongside Maze. But yeah, jumping back into 6 minutes into the game, Helios will just have to take a step back again because Mitsuha is a tad bit too aggressive for him, that, and he does not want to juggle that possible 1v3. Orthroz alongside Sayonara, they are this three champion hunting squad. Looks like Caustic University, they will be doing a possible 1-3-1 setup.
Yeah, not just that. I think Helios going back is a good call because when you're looking at the items as well, he still doesn't have any damaged items in his pocket. So when it comes down to it, he needs to wait for that. He only has Burning Geese in his inventory that he can use for that setups up against Cosmic University. So that late game is something that RRQ really wants.
Mm-hmm. They really, really want it indeed. But apparently we are a few minutes out from it. It's just 7 minutes in.
A bit later.
I guess the reason why RRQ doesn't want to pick these pickoffs or fights is because, like what you said, they just want to prolong the game as long as they can. I mean, you have a Renekton, an Orianna, and the Kai'Sa in your lineup. Of course, you'd want to bank on the late game. Cosmic University, basically, they have this certain time in the game that they have to finish. If they allow the game to prolong or go any longer, looks like the advantages will just go over to RRQ. But optimizations, Robo already available for this Diana. Static Shiv already being picked up by Lara One. You also have the Leandris available for Helios and also another Blade of the Ruined King for Renekton.
Yeah, and a while ago, we said it in the graph when Orcus picked up Soraka. We are talking about items, we want to talk about items as well. He's going in for the Fimbul Winter first item for that sustainability, or not even sustainability, but rather the armor coming from the item and also the mana included from the tier of the goddess here for Soraka. He wants that, and the next item will be that sustainability armor for that HP regen. Let's see how it would turn out for them, because this is something that I want to see, especially that Nunu and Willump is there on his team. Very tanky.
Barf Balls being used by Nunu here. Looks like they just really want to secure that buff, but RRQ is still lurking into the sides. Most, if not all, of the champions here in team number one, they're mostly at the lower right half of the map. Looks like they, honestly, they're just waiting for one opening, and then that is where they're gonna go all in. They have to remember, Cosmic University needs to remember that there is still the ultimate coming out from this Janna, that Moonsoon, which can really turn things around. You just push your opponents or even save your very own team, which is probably why Cosmic University, they're not pulling the trigger just yet. Unless Mitsuha does something.
Maybe. If Mitsuha does something, yes, it could change things up for Cosmic University. Although right now, it's still gonna be nothing. It's only one kill
Nada.
For both teams. 32.5k for both teams as well when it comes to gold. There is the dragon. There is the Rift Herald next though. And I think this will be the source of change and a catalyst for both teams to go for the clash, the gift of something.
Cosmic University finally decides to do something. Could be a bait, could be not, but let's see. Looks like RRQ, they are very much enticed with this possible dragon. Take that is gonna be the ultimate being popped. He does become rooted, but then is the machine jumping in. You have Wish being used by this Orthros. Let's see who will be the first one to say goodbye. That is gonna be Garen being able to burst down that crocodile with his sword. And again, Nunu and Willump jumping out, actually pushing out some bark walls, and it looks like they will rotate over to the mid lane. Take that outer mid lane turret down and then go in with the recall. Very nice micro coming in for Cosmic University.
Yeah, and right now, Cosmic University, when they beat down high, they have the numbers advantage and immediately goes for the Rift Herald.
Mm-hmm. Looks like RRQ, again, they would still want to contest, but no ultimate for Shin. Jara is in the shockwave connecting all the three, but looks like it is not enough. Instead, Nunu gets a kill onto the jungler. Another minus one for the champions of RRQ. Red team being able to get that Rift Herald with smiles on their faces. And again, they will just take a step back. Now, the men in red, they are the ones at the lead. That is going to be Judgment being popped by this Garen, but it looks like Marky will not fully commit, and instead instead, I will just take out some minions.
Well, now I know what the item is. I keep on thinking about it a while ago since the draft. I was like, what is this item?
What was an item?
But it's Warlord's Armor, ladies and gents. I think this is the HP regen item that I was keep on talking about. This is the traditional one for Orcas that we've seen from their day one matches from week two, and it's now coming into fruition. The next item will probably be sort of a mana or maybe more AP for himself, but the silence is something that we need to look out for later on for Orcs, because especially for RRQ, they have Hyde, they have Chaz. If that gets silenced, they will say goodbye.
Can I just say that there's basically two neutralizers, two silencers from Cosmic University. So if you thought you're safe right after receiving the silence from Dawn, think again, because there's still Orthros that can silence you in the perfect time. But yeah, for now, Cosmic University, they do not want to fight. They do not want to pick offs. Instead, they still want that buff there. This is very textbook Wild Rift, you know. Just get as much items, as much gold as you can. Roam around the map, try to control the tempo of the game against your opponents and just, you know, push as much waves as you can. Ergo, what Diana did, what Mitsura did at the Baron Lane.
Yeah, and this is just a waiting game for now for RRQ. They're just waiting steadily. And if you're seeing right now, if Cosmic University tries to go for that early hyper-aggression engage, RRQ doesn't want to fight it. Not only because of the 3.5k gold lead for Cosmic University, but also the statement that Kai'Sa still needs a couple of more items to have that power spike.
Mm-hmm. It has, you know, the Ruined King available, and then the Curve Arrow. Now, Cosmic University, they're not only are they getting the buffs and the objectives, but also the Rip Scuttler. So, RIP for Chaz there. This jungler is still looking for ways to actually catch someone off guard or maybe even ramp up some damage for himself. This is a very scary death brush. Looks like whoever faces face checks first will die. But you forgot, Kai'Sa still has the Void Seeker, was able to get that vision in. And with that, Cosmic University, let's not try to surprise your opponents. Instead, let's just try to get Baron down to the last 10-11k of his life. But looks like Cosmic University, they only had first dibs on the Baron as a bait for RRQ. Hyde will be alone. We'll just try to keep his attention on this Rip Herald.
Okay, never mind.
Was gonna be a fight too. I thought you were ready to play by play.
I was looking at the minimap. I was like, top lane. Kai'Sa's alone. But you know what? Never mind. It's Cosmic University just strolling around, going for an exploration journey, just clearing out the wave on top side. But I think that's important to take note. If RRQ keeps on doing this, especially the ADC on lurking around, unattended for his teammates, it's going to be so much devastating for Cosmic University to punish.
It'll be very much devastating indeed. Looks like, okay, RRQ did get first dibs on Dragon. They actually got a Cloud Dragon, but now they're going to try to go with the steal, but it's not going to be enough because, again, Cosmic University was able to get their hands on that juicy purple worm. Shockwave coming out from Helios, but it was just not timed enough and it was not converted into a kill. One thing they were able to get, though, aside from the Dragon, is this first outer mid lane turret from Cosmic University side.
Well, hashtag worth it for Cosmic University. Even if they lost Cloud Dragon, they have the Baron Nashor to further punish RRQ. And I think when you're looking at it, what would you get? Baron Nashor or the Cloud Dragon? So I think that's also already a key stated point for Cosmic University, having that pressure in, having that pressure advantage in all lanes. If they can even at least get only one turret or even two turrets, they have this gold lead up against RRQ even further down than 2k gold.
Oh yeah, 2k gold indeed. You also have, that is going to be a 2k gold in favor of Cosmic University. And this is a very long game compared to the tempo that we had in the series number one today. But still, you know, different teams, different plans, different series, and different plays in Wild Rift. Hyde is still taking his sweet time, but now you have three champions down at the Dragon Lane. This is a fresh wave of Baron buff minions, and it looks like Cosmic University, they smell blood. They have the silence and the damage coming through from Orthros, but looks like they will not be able to reach this Soraka. Helios being able to use that command protect as well as the command attack. He is just throwing out the orbs to see if he'll be able to catch anyone because he has the shockwave available. You also have Instinct available for this Kai'Sa.
Snowball.
Snowball. Okay, that's cute enough. That's good enough. Nice try, Sayonara. With that, Cosmic University was able to clean out the outer turrets for
Moonfall?
The Dragon Lane side. Question mark, Moonfall. I mean, I believe Mitsura thought someone from RRQ would walk in that area, considering that it's very small and very compact. But the fact that Hyde still had Flash, he just walked his way to the upper part of the jungle. I guess it was just this risk that Mitsura took. Apparently, he did not get any kill, did not get any gold or EXP at all. But it's okay, you know, it happens.
Mm-hmm. And this is what we talked about a while ago. If you have the Baron Nashor, Cosmic University got a turret. And now, they are at 4k gold lead up against RRQ, and that gold lead is actually quite massive when you're talking about RRQ's need for gold. They're hungry for gold, they need that for their Kai'Sa, but now, it is already the Infinity Edge. It's the BRK, it's the Rune and Surikin locked and loaded for Kai'Sa in this matchup, and now I think we can see maybe RRQ starting up some fights to make those three core items for Kai'Sa be in use.
Actually, oh yeah, RRQ, they are still yet to start the fight.
Yeah.
I mean, we only ever saw Cosmic University trying to hunt, trying to look for, or rather take a kill onto either Hyde or Marky. Most of the time, Hyde is the one that got taken down, like two deaths out of the three kills that Cosmic University has. It's a pretty chill game, as I'd like to label it, but I guess both teams, they really love their macro. Even in different tournaments, whenever RRQ plus Cosmic University will face each other, it's the same story. Games are just stretched as long as they need, as long as they want, because their ADC, they're making and waiting for the time that their ADC can just take out everyone. But speaking of taking out someone or something, Cosmic University having first dibs on this Purple Worm, on this Baron Chaz, does get quite the personal, or rather does get quite personal when it comes to Cosmic University, but pokes are being sent out by the men in red. Ultimate no longer available for Hyde, so that's something Cosmic University was able to note. Another huge slime being rolled over by Sayonara. We will connect on to one, but apparently there is no follow-up. Instead, he will be forced to take so much damage. It's going to be the ultimate coming out from Hughes, but that is going to be also off the damage being actually getting out from the side of Cosmic University. But you know who has more damage? Marky on this Kai'Sa. And with that, RRQ, they're on the chase. Marky does get a triple kill. He's now killing spree. It was a 5-2 in favor of RRQ.
Now, the mistake for Cosmic University is going alone. It was Sayonara. Yes, I want to say that he wants to set up that play for his team, but he was soloing on that 1v5 to set up for RRQ, where in fact, we keep on stating that Kai'Sa already has Infinity Edge, BRK, and Rune and Surikin.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. I guess they just really needed one ace. That was, if I may say, that was anticlimactic because they were dragging on the game so long. But then RRQ ever needed just one ace, and then they were able to convert it to a win for the game. That was actually a beautiful game. Need to go online in the late game, and then you will just do your thing, and we will just go with the support and just take everyone out. This is a very low kill comp, by the way. 6 kills over to RRQ. And CU only ever had 5 kills in their pockets, but it was almost 20 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
That's how long and that's how tactical these two teams are. Marky, of course, will stand proud with that 3-0-2. Hyde, he actually received a lot of damage even though he died a handful of times. I believe RRQ, they were able to make this lineup work. One good ultimate from Helios, good sustain, good shielding from Maze, and Marky will just do his thing for the side of Cosmic University. They were the aggressive ones in game number one. But apparently, when it mattered, it just went over to RRQ.
Yeah, simply the storyline for this game is RRQ playing very, 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 that's multiple
mm-hmm.
varies to enumerate my point, that they're playing very safe. Because they're really waiting for Marky. And as you all know, as you stated, Cosmic University, aggression. This is their name. This is what they were known for domestically, even prior to Cosmic University, in another team, that they are hyper-aggressive team. But instead of being a beneficial thing for them, it was instead a risk. It was instead something of a deficit for them because RRQ was easily just set up the play and punish them for it. So in the next